Hello friends, welcome to CCN lab. We have completed with your experiment number 3, which goes something like this, and we have done this and we have calculated the throughput by changing your error rate and data rate. Today, moving on with the next experiment, that is experiment number 4, the aim of the experiment number 4 goes something like this, wherein we will try to implement Ethernet LAN using N nodes and assign multiple traffic to the nodes and obtain congestion window for different sources and destination, that is sources or destination. So if you observe your experiment number 3 and your experiment number 4, both are very similar. There is not much difference here. Only small first change is there we have considered nodes 6 to 10. Here we will be considering N nodes. The second very important difference is here in experiment number 3 we have calculated your throughput, but in your experiment number 4 we will be trying to obtain a congestion window. That is the only difference. Rest all steps and procedures remains very similar. So when we speak of congestion windows, we will be speaking this congestion in terms of drops and collisions, that is how many packets have been dropped and how many packets have been collided. That we'll try to calculate using your NC2NS network simulator. So going ahead, we'll directly jump to your virtual environment, wherein you know what are the steps involved in starting this virtual environment. If you have any doubts, you can go through videos of experiment number 1 and you can just follow the steps which have been told there, like you should go through dispatcher, coordinator and NC2NS client. Once you go through all those steps, you will be getting this screen wherein you will be doing your software. Okay, so this is the tool which you will be using. As we are told, the first step is draw. So I'll be drawing the host, which is very similar to your previous experiment. So I will take here 3 hosts on one side and other 3 hosts on the other side. So this is done. Next, I will take the hub. So this is your hub. So I'll take the hub. So I'll make 2 hubs. One is for sender and one is for receiver. Next, I'll take the switch. So that we'll connect through the switch. Then I will join all these things with the help of a point-to-point link. So I'll take a point-to-point link and I'll try to connect them. So here I have connected the first one, second one, and third one. Similarly, on the other end for the receiver side, this connection is done. Finally, from the switch to up. So we have made all the connections. Just I will make it properly. I will redraw the whole structure so that it looks correct. So this is your one side. One is sender and another one is receiver. Okay. So I will just put a label here saying that this is my sender. And here I will put a label saying that this is my receiver, similar to how we had done in your previous experiment. Next, we will go to edit. Okay, so we will go to edit. So we are editing it. Say I will put the experiment name as experiment number 4. Again, it's a .tpl file. So we have done it. So after doing this, you can see here various IPs have been generated. That is 1.0.1 and so on. Next, we will go ahead and try to edit the host. So the same procedure, I will go to add, then I will add a command for the sender changing the stop time. So it is nothing but stg minus u space 1024 space 100 space 1.0.1.4. 4 is nothing but it is the IP of the receiver. Okay, so this is done. So I'll copy this because it would be used repeatedly now. So I'll press OK. Then we'll go to node editor, then Mac. So we'll select here log. Only small difference here is we'll be selecting your drops and collision of the packet, that is number of collisions and number of drops. That's all. So this is done. FIFO, I'll check whether it is 50 packets. Yes, press enter. So we are done with the first one. Similarly, we'll do it for the second one. I'll go to add, I'll change it to 20. The same command, I'll just change the IP address to 5, press OK. Then node editor, here again I should select your collision and drop packets. So we'll be selecting your collision and drop package. Okay, so next we'll go to FIFO. And say okay. So we'll go to 20. So the IP address is 1.0.1.6. So I'll go to Mac. Again, I need to select your collision and drop packets. Okay, so press OK. Go to FIFO. Say packet length is 50. Yeah, this is done. So this is done for all the sender side. Similarly, we'll do it for the receiver side. Just a small change in the command. Here the command would be, it would go something like this: RTG space minus U minus W LOG 1. So you already know the meaning of it. It is nothing but R stands for receiver, TG dash U stands for, it is a UDP command, W is nothing but write, and writing in the log file. That's all. So copy this, say OK, go to Node Editor, we'll go to Mac, and then here again we'll be selecting your collision and drop packets. Say OK. Go to FIFO, just check whether it's 50 or not. Yeah, so this is done. Similarly, we'll do for the other two receivers. Again, go to add. The command for all the receivers will remain the same. It is same. Only small change, there is no change in your at the receiver end. Go to Mac, select your collision and drop packets, say enter. Finally, for the last one, add. One second, I need to do your Node Editor. So Node Editor, Mac, select the log, number of collisions, number of drops, say OK. So this is done. After doing this, the last thing is remaining is we need to put the characteristics of the switch. So go to switch, double click on switch, then on your Node Editor, we need to go for the physical structure. So go for the physical structure, change the bandwidth. Bandwidth could be anything. For now, I am taking the bandwidth as 5 and error rate as 0.1. It is of your choice. You can put anything. Similarly for the other end. So keep here 5, put error rate of your choice. I have taken here again 0.1 and press OK. OK, so this is done. So check with Mac. No need to do any changes with the Mac. Press enter. So all your settings are done. So I guess these are done, and then the next step is to go for the run. So it will ask, do you want to save it? Say yes, and then your simulation you need to do. So go to simulation and say run. So just check in the down, is it running? Yeah, it is running. You can observe here the simulation is running. Okay. So once you are done with the simulation, the last step is to go for the play. So the simulation is done. Say OK. OK. Yeah. So the last step is your play button. So I will play this now. So you can see. So I'll pause it for a while. So you can see the data transfer is happening. So you can see the blue lines, whatever you can see, those are nothing but your data transfers. So if I play it again, you can see the data transfer is happening from the sender. It will move to your hub. From the hub, it will move to switch. Then from the switch, again to the hub. Then to your receivers, respective receivers. Okay, friends. So this is done. The last step remaining is to see what are our various graphs. So to see the graphs, go to GTools, say plot graph, say file, say open. Then this is your experiment number 4 results. Say I'll be checking your various collisions of N1P1. So select N1P1. So I would like to see one more. So we are taken for N1P1. Similarly, we'll see the N1P1 drops. Okay. So this N1P1 drops are, you can see the difference. So next we'll go for the n2. So graph 2, say open n2 p1. So n1 p1 here we had seen, we are seeing now n2 p1. Similarly, we'll also see the drops, say new, say graph 4, say open, and say n2 p1 drop. Okay, so as you can observe here, friends, these are our various graphs of our n1, n2. The blue color, this is n1 p1 collision, this is drop, this is n2 p1 collision, and this is n2 p1 drop. So these graphs are denoting what are the number of collisions and drops. So this ends your experiment number 4. Thank you for watching. If you have any doubts, you can call or WhatsApp.